Could you discuss some of your circadian resolutions for 2021? Things maybe that anyone could use, anyone could follow as well.
Yeah, so we thought, okay, so how do we put all of this together? Because we talk about light, we talk about sleep, not having light exposure before sleep, having light exposure during day. It can be all confusing. So we thought an ideal circadian day might be try to be in bed for 8 hours consistently every night. When I say consistently, try to go to bed within an hour window and be in bed for 8 hours so that you can get 7 hours, 7.5 hours of sleep if you're an adult. And then after waking up, try to avoid food for 1 to 2 hours, because that's when your melatonin hormone is slowly going down and cortisol hormone is spiking. And then after waiting for an hour or two, have your first bite and then count 8, 10, 11 or maximum 12 hours. That's the window of time when you should be eating. And also make sure that the last bite or the last calorie is at least 2 hours before your bedtime. You don't want to have that last calorie too close to the bedtime, so that you can avoid food and avoid bright light for 2 to 3 hours before bedtime. And then during the daytime, particularly in the first half of the day, if you can, try to go outside. Even if it's a cloudy day, there is enough light to uplift your mood, because light is the best antidepressant. It's plentiful and free. You just have to step outside. And when you're stepping outside, you can also take a brisk walk for 30 minutes. And that way you can get both your exercise and light dose of the day. So that's the bottom line. 8 hours in bed, wait for 1 or 2 hours before fast calorie, eat everything within 8 to maximum 12 hours. No food and no bright light for 2 to 3 hours before bedtime. And 30 minutes outdoor, brisk walking during the day.
Great pointers. So thank you so much, Satchin, for having this Clubhouse chat. People can follow you obviously on Clubhouse, but you're also on Twitter at Satchin Panda. Your website's mycircadianclock.org. Your book, which is fantastic, and I read a couple of years ago, My Circadian Code, has a lot of the information we talked about today and so much more. Also, your ongoing crowdsourced data using your My Circadian Clock app that's available on the App Store or Google Play. Is there anything else that people can find you or you want to direct them to?
No, you had a very comprehensive list. We actually like when people, the My Circadian Clock app is an academic app, so it's not as fancy as some of the other apps. But I'm really grateful that thousands of people have shared their eating habits, sleep habits, step habits, and their socioeconomic demographic information. And that has been extremely useful for many ongoing and future studies. We have nearly now 10 different clinical studies going on in parallel on the My Circadian Clock app platform. And then the book has been very gratifying, because the book has been now translated to 10 different languages. And through the book, while writing the book, I also came to understand how to think of my experiments in the light of public health, and whether we do an experiment in Drosophila fly or mouse, we're always thinking, is it going to have an impact? So that opened my eyes. And Rhonda, you are the first one who I remember the first time I did a podcast, that was with you. That was the first time I didn't know what is a podcast. And when I got an email from Rhonda, I went back to the lab and I asked, what is a podcast? And a lot of people explained to me. And here we are again. So Rhonda, you're always ahead of all of us, and you are doing a fantastic job in communicating science to millions of people, because we scientists, we are not very good at that. And science has to be disseminated, and thank you for doing such a fantastic, fabulous job.
Oh, I appreciate that, Satchin. Thank you. And for those of you here on Clubhouse listening, this conversation was recorded, and you can find that podcast on your favorite podcast player. Just search for Found My Fitness. You can also sign up for our newsletter on foundmyfitness.com and keep up to date with all the things we're doing, including podcasts like this one. So thanks again, Satchin, and I look forward to talking to you soon and keeping up with all your wonderful research.
Yeah, thank you, and have a perfect circadian day.
All right, sounds good. You do the same. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.